Earl Spence says the fight with Crawford is close as possible, but if it doesn't happen now, it's never going to happen. What do you think? Does it happen?
Of course, Earl knows, and he's a man with him. He's the negotiator. He said, yeah, if it doesn't happen now, it probably never happen.
So who wins?
I'm going to pick, I like Bud over that fight. I like Earl too, but I like Bud over that fight. But, you know, like Earl says, he's right there. He's in the middle of it. He knows if it's not going to happen now, it doesn't, probably doesn't happen.
So you said Crawford. What do you say?
I say Crawford, but he's got to keep him on. If he can see, keep him on the outside.
Yeah,
he's very good.
Crawford or Spence?
If Crawford make his distance moving, he beat Spence. If Spence give him his boxing in a close distance and
hits him,
hit him, no stop, he win.
Crawford likes to go toe-to-toe.
Sometimes. Although going toe-to-toe with Spence is a bit different.
Look, they're both champions. It's a great fight. I hope we see it, because that's the one fight all the fans want to see.
Yeah, it's a good fight. It's all the fans want to see it. And it's a good fight, like Spence says. It needs to happen now, though.
By the way, Sergei, have you ever been in camp with Pacquiao? You train with him a little bit?
No.
Not yet. So maybe this time he could train with Manny. If Manny comes back one more fight?
If they take me...
Well, you're talking to his coach over here. He might be. He's talking about it. First exhibition, but maybe a real fight. Justin says he wants Manny against the winner of Spence and Crawford. That would be a big fight.
Yeah.
Imagine if Manny pulls it off.
Legend.
Yeah, it's boxing shit.
They take me in the Philippines. We'll go watch the Philippines. I never be there.
Let's go. I've never been either.
Yeah, let's go together.
Just not yet. No. I've been to Thailand, Taiwan. I've just not been. I've been to China many times, but not Philippines yet. I was waiting for Manny to do a camp out there.
China, Taiwan, and...
Time to go. But Russia and China, very close.
Yeah.
And you never go visit.
No, it's not very close. From Moscow, it's, I think... Flight, like 10 hours.
Yeah, I know. I'm joking that they're close, but I'm saying the border's enough for it. So, Sergei, August
is too big. It's from Russia somewhere. You fly 12 hours other place. Same flight I hear from Moscow. I fly 12 hours here.
August 20th, what's your prediction? What do you think?
August 20th, I come back and... I train hard. We have a best trainer in the corner, and I hope everybody like my comeback.
Have you seen him change since he got here, Justin? Is he changed? Has he added anything? Is he taking?
He's punching so much harder.
He's already been a very big puncher.
Yeah, no more. He punches way harder.
Okay.
Not balanced anymore. He punches much harder. He's probably
shooting. You hitting harder? Do you hear it?
I think so, yeah.
I hear it. I feel it.
So. He's a dangerous man.
Yeah.
You know he had 500 kickboxing matches?
500?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, how many did you win?
Maybe more.
Maybe more. We don't count all of them.
I knock out.
You don't count the ones in the street?
After 500, I knock out because it's...
You stop counting?
Yeah.
How many did you win of 500 kickboxing?
I lose like maybe 15, maybe 10 fights.
How crazy is that, Justin? Just to do that in any sport, like to do something?
You know, when I be 16 or 14 years older, when I go one, it's a 3-4 day, yeah?
Tournament.
Tournament. And I fight two fights, knockout guys, and one day rest, and next day I need to...
Two more guys.
Final, yeah? And when I rest, my coach, hey, let's go. We'll watch other fights and other tournament. It's only one day tournament, like a fast. I go there watching, and you wanna fight? And, okay.
You came to why not?
Okay, why not? And I have 2-4 guys in the weights, and it's to fight more. And I knock out these two guys. go back and. In a tournament, rest Saturday and win again and come back with two medals and a home.
You know, it's crazy. Every kickboxer that I know, goes to boxing. Everybody. You, Chris Algieri, he was a world champion. You were a world champion. Who else was a kickboxer? That...
Klitschko's. From Russian, Povetkin.
Enrique was a kickboxing champion. From Georgia, a boxer, 13-0. You don't know?
No.
Okay. But why is that? Why don't they stay in kickboxing? Why everybody boxing? That's it? Just money? You did kickboxing too, right?
Yeah, whatever it is.
Everybody, kickboxer, make money in boxing. He make money in kickboxing.
You make money in kickboxing? How do you do that?
You got K1?
All my friends were fucking fighters, and I was tired of getting kicks. So then, but that's a whole different level. That's K1 heavyweight in the 90s.
But everybody, those Van Damme movies, there were a lot of movies of kickboxing. That's why you did it?
Yeah, that's why we go in the kickboxing.
Yeah, but no money in it, unfortunately. But it's a very hard sport.
Yeah, no money.
Why not?
It's very hard sport, yeah. It's
sparring when I was fighting.
Uh-huh.
A wild card. And I used to just go there and ask for sparring partners. So I go there, and they're like, oh, yeah, spar this guy, because no one wanted to spar him, right? He's like, oh, what's his record? I was like, he's like 2-0. So I just went in there.
You're thinking you're a badass.
Yeah, I did like 6 rounds with him a couple times.
And then black guys and all that.
Like, yeah, you hard, you know.
Sergey, where do people follow you, the fans? Instagram?
Yeah, Instagram, Sergey Lipinets.
Make sure to follow him. Stay tuned right here. Fortune Gym, putting in work. Tell him where to follow you.
Kaizama Boxing.
Stay tuned. Kaizama Boxing. Elisek back reporting.